Google Cloud SQL allows you to easily create, run, and manage MySQL databases on Google's infrastructure. I'm going to show you how to create a Cloud SQL database, then demo how to connect to it from standard tools, and from applications running on Compute Engine and App Engine. To get started, let's jump over to the Cloud Console. I'll start with selecting the Cloud SQL service and then clicking the New Instance button to create a new instance. The first thing to specify is the instance ID. We'll call this instance Sample Demo. We'll leave the region set to United States, but we can also create instances that live in the EU. Since we're only using this instance for a demo, we'll choose the smallest instance, D0, for our tier. And for the billing plan, we'll go with the per-use option to be charged by the hour. This way, we'll only pay for the database when we're actually using it. Under the options, we have the ability to specify a specific backup window and choose the type of replication that should be used. I'll just go with the defaults. We'll need an IP address for our instance to connect to it, so we'll select the Assign IP Address option. Finally, there's the setting for specifying authorized App Engine applications. The default App Engine app associated with this project is currently the only authorized application. We'll leave this as it is for now. On the right side of the page, there's a nice summary of the current instance settings. That looks good. Let's click the Confirm button to create the instance. We can see here that the instance is being created. Once the process of creating the instance completes, we'll be able to check out its details and start using it right away. Now the instance is created. Let's select our new instance and take a look at the details. The status is running, great. Notice that you can click the Edit button to change the settings of your database instance on the fly. For example, you could change the tier size if you determine that you need more or less RAM. Now that we've got our instance running, let's connect to it. We can connect from any MySQL tool or application such as Toad or MySQL Workbench, but we'll start by using the standard MySQL command line client. It's part of the MySQL Community Server software bundle, so once you've got that installed, you can start using the MySQL client, and I've already got it installed. At the moment, nothing has been authorized to connect to our instance. That's the default for maximum security. I'll select Access Control to allow access from my client machine. The first thing we'll need is a MySQL user and password. For this demo, we'll be connecting as the root user, so we'll give the root user a password. And click Set to save it. Next, we'll need to add the IP address of the machine I'm connecting with. On a Mac or Linux machine, you can type the terminal command ifconfig to find your machine's IP address. On a Windows machine, it's ipconfig. Or you can just do a Google search for what is my IP address. I'll click on Add Authorized Network, enter the IP address of my machine, and click Add to authorize it. I won't bother setting up an encrypted connection for now, but you should use it for all production databases. Now let's jump to a terminal window to test our connection. Here's the command I'll run. We'll type MySQL, followed by the IP address of our Cloud SQL instance for the host, and then the user flag set to root, and finally the password flag without a value. When we run that, we'll be prompted for our password. After entering the password, we are now connected to our Cloud SQL instance. Let's confirm that by running a Show Databases query. And we get back the list of default databases included with MySQL. Now let's run a script to create a database with a single table containing a small sample of data from Wikipedia. Here's the script we'll run. It's just a standard MySQL script. For example, it could be a dump of an existing database you want to move to the cloud. Here's where we create the database. And here's our use statement to select the new database. This statement creates our table with two columns specified. The remaining statements will insert data into our newly created table. Okay, let's jump back to the MySQL prompt and run the script. The command to run the script is source. So we'll type source followed by the location of the script, and hit enter to run it. There, our database has been created. We should now be able to run a query to test that all our data is what we expect. We'll run the query. Select name, size from stars, and hit enter. And there's our table with the data that we just inserted. Now that we've got some sample data in Cloud SQL, let's look at how we can use a Google Compute Engine instance to query Cloud SQL from a PHP page. Here's the Cloud Console, where you can see that I've already created a VM within Compute Engine. It's already got PHP and Apache installed on it. I've also created a firewall within Compute Engine to allow internet requests on port 80. We can see that by going to the Network section and selecting our default network. Here under the Firewall section, you can see that I've already created a firewall named HTTP1 and it's set up to allow traffic on port 80. Now let's SSH into our VM and test running a PHP page that connects to Cloud SQL. I'll click on my instance PHP demo to get the SSH link. And we'll use that to SSH into the VM. And we're on our VM. Again, we need to get the external IP address of this Compute Engine VM so that we can allow access to it from Cloud SQL. Back in the Cloud Console, we can copy the VM's external IP address here. Then we'll go back to the Cloud SQL Access Control section. And click Add New under the Authorized Network section. Finally, we'll paste in the VM's IP address and click Add. Now let's go back to the terminal window that's SSH'd into our Compute Engine VM. I'll create a new PHP page called index.php in the var www directory where Apache is serving web pages from. I've got the PHP code in an editor on my local machine. Here's the connection to Cloud SQL, and here's where we select our database. Here's the query that will be run, and here's where the code sends the query to Cloud SQL and outputs the results to the web page. The remainder of the code is some CSS styling for the HTML, along with some JavaScript to format our numbers with commas. I'll select all of that and copy it and paste it back in our index.php page and save the file. Now we should be able to open a new browser tab and paste in the IP address of our VM and the file name of our new index.php page. And there's our PHP page displaying our data from Cloud SQL. Now what about using a web-based database management tool like phpMyAdmin? Using the same Compute Engine VM, we can try this out quickly. The VM already has phpMyAdmin installed, so the only remaining thing we need to do to try out our phpMyAdmin setup is to specify the IP address of our Cloud SQL instance as the default server. We can do that by editing the config.inc.php configuration file with the following command. We'll type sudo nano and the location of the file to edit it. Then we'll jump down where you can optionally specify the server host. Here, we can uncomment this line and change localhost to be the IP address of our Cloud SQL instance. And we'll close the file and save the changes. Now we should be able to open up a new browser tab and enter the external IP address of our VM plus phpMyAdmin. And there's the phpMyAdmin login screen. We'll enter root as the username and specify the password that we set up previously for Cloud SQL in the Cloud Console. For the server choice, we'll choose the IP address of our Cloud SQL instance and click Go. And we're in. We can select our Big Stars database and then view the data in the Stars table. That looks good. We can now administer our entire database from phpMyAdmin. We can see the databases. We can run SQL queries, monitor statistics, and so on, all through a web front end. Great. Now let's take that same PHP page that we previously ran on Compute Engine and run it on Google App Engine. I've already created an App Engine application called Cloud SQL Sample. The next thing we'll need to do is to authorize access to Cloud SQL from our App Engine app. Here in the Cloud SQL Access Control settings, under the section titled Authorize App Engine Applications, we'll click the Add New link, and then enter the app ID of our app. And then click the Add button to authorize our App Engine application to connect to our Cloud SQL instance. Now let's jump back to our terminal window. Here's the PHP page that we ran on Google Compute Engine. The only modification that we have to make for it to run on App Engine is to update the connection string. We'll replace the Cloud SQL instance IP address with the string :\cloudsql/, followed by our project ID, and then colon, and then the name of our Cloud SQL instance. Then I'll set the password to be an empty string, since we've already authorized our App Engine application's connection to Cloud SQL in the Cloud Console. I've already deployed this updated PHP page out to our App Engine application, so now we should be able to open a new browser tab and then go to our App Engine app. And there's our PHP page with data from Cloud SQL. Excellent. I've just showed you a very simple demonstration of creating a Cloud SQL database along with different ways that you can connect to Cloud SQL to manage your databases, from standard tools, from applications running on Compute Engine, and from applications on App Engine. I've also showed you how to use Cloud SQL as the data source for your web pages. Here are a few resources where you can go to learn more. Now that you've seen how quickly you can get started, try it out for yourself and start using Cloud SQL right now. Thank you for watching.